My name is Jimmy Mack, and I'm going to be with you for the next few minutes as we go through emergency school bus evacuation procedures. Most of the time, you get on your bus and ride to and from school without any problems. As a matter of fact, it's very unusual for any problems of any kind to occur. But we still must be prepared just in case an emergency evacuation is called for. So, what does evacuation mean?
It means to get off the bus as safe and as quick as you can.
It means get off the bus safely and as quickly as you can when your driver tells you to. And in our case, emergency means...
It's not safe to stay on the bus.
It's not safe to remain in the bus. One thing that's very important for everyone to understand is when you're on the school bus, the driver is your boss. What he or she says is exactly what you must do. The driver's job is to keep everyone safe at all times. So, it's very important that you pay close attention to what he or she says and follow instructions just the way they're given to you.
Students, it's important that you know your bus driver and your driver know you. Most importantly, you should always do exactly what your bus driver says to do. Remember, it's the bus driver's job to get you to school and back home in a safe manner. Remember, the driver is the boss of the bus.
What are some of the reasons we might have to have an emergency evacuation of your school bus? If there is a fire or possibility of a fire on your bus or near your bus, and your bus driver thinks it's a danger to your safety, that's a reason to evacuate. If there is an accident and your bus is damaged so it cannot be driven, your bus driver will likely ask you to evacuate the bus. If your bus breaks down in the middle of a busy intersection or anywhere where there's a possibility of being run into by another vehicle, your driver might ask you to evacuate the bus. If your bus stops running near a hilltop or sharp curve where other motorists cannot see the bus and your bus driver cannot see other traffic, you may be asked to evacuate the bus.
If you can't see traffic, traffic can't see you, and that's not good.
If the bus has stopped near the edge of a steep drop-off, or if there's a possibility the bus could roll into water, the driver will ask you to evacuate the bus. If the bus stops near or on a railroad track, you'll be asked to evacuate.
If there's a contest between a school bus and a train, the train will win every time.
Sometimes, severe weather may be a reason to evacuate. There may be other reasons to evacuate the bus, but these are the most common. Not all emergencies require you to exit the bus. Sometimes the safest place in an emergency situation is inside the bus. Your driver will decide what is best.
There are times when it's safer to be on the bus than it is to be outside the bus. But remember, your bus driver will be the one to make this decision.
Your bus driver will always be thinking about your safety and do whatever is necessary to protect you from harm. There are several places to get off the bus. Your driver will determine which one is the best.
Remember, your bus driver is always in charge, and he'll be the one to decide in every situation the way that you're to get off the bus.
Of course, you can get off from the front door. There's also an emergency door located in the rear of the bus. Sometimes students will exit from both the front door and rear emergency exit at the same time. Students in the front half of the bus will exit through the front door, while students in the back half of the bus will use the rear emergency exit. In unusual situations, windows on either side of the bus may be open for students to climb through.
Your bus may also be equipped with emergency exit windows. There could be two or there could be four. There are two here on this bus and there are two back there. In order to operate those, you lift up the red handle and then you push straight out. These will only be used in an emergency where you cannot get out in any of the doors.
And finally, there are escape hatches in the roof of some buses that are only used in very unusual situations.
Your bus also may be equipped with two roof hatches. These can be used and utilized if you turn the red handle toward the arrow and then push them up in order to climb out of the bus. These should only be used in emergencies where the bus is turned over on its side.
Don't ever come out of here unless your bus driver tells you to.
These are very special escape hatches. Not all buses have them. They're only used in very unusual circumstances and should never be opened unless your driver says so. When it's necessary to evacuate, remain seated until your driver or an assistant gives you instructions. Normally, the bus will be unloaded, starting with the seats closest to the door. The driver or his assistant will evacuate one seat at a time. First one side, then the other. This keeps things orderly and safe. If you're exiting from an emergency door, you'll first sit, then let assistants outside the door help you off. Never jump out an emergency door. Whichever exit your driver tells you to use, the important thing is to move quietly and orderly. Do exactly what your driver says.
Students, remember, in an emergency situation, you must stay calm, be cool, follow the rules. Remember, follow the bus driver's instructions.
The most important thing is to stay calm and do whatever your driver tells you. You can imagine if everyone tried to get through an exit at one time, people could easily get hurt. As you leave the bus, you'll be sent to a safe area, which will be at least 100 feet away from the bus. Getting away from the bus keeps students out of harm's way. Being prepared for an emergency school bus evacuation is very important. Knowing what to do, when, and how to do it can prevent unnecessary accidents. First of all, your bus is equipped with a first aid kit, fire extinguisher, and radio communication system. These can all be important in an emergency situation.
On the side, there's a button. You'll push that button down and call and just say, "This is bus 580. I need help." Okay, on each and every bus, there's certain safety equipment that are required. One is a first aid kit. That is there for anyone that gets injured on the bus or through an incident. Then there's a 5-pound fire extinguisher that's on each and every bus. They're mounted at the front of the bus, so they're easy to get to. There's a biohazard cleanup kit that's to protect you in case of any body fluids that may get on the ground so that you won't come in contact with any viruses or unknown agents that may be available. Also, each bus should have a procedure card, or in our case, our drivers have a notebook that they have, that on that it lists the emergency procedures that they're to follow if there's an incident or an accident on a school bus. Your bus is probably going to be also equipped with a two-way radio that will keep you in contact with your dispatcher. If there's a problem on the bus, and as a student you may need to use that, you need to be sure that you have the microphone to the radio. It has a button on the side that you depress, and you keep that depressed and tell them what bus number you are and what your location is so they can send you some help.
Your bus driver has been trained in emergency procedures, but he'll need help. A driver will pick up to 5 helpers who ride on your bus. These students may be older and live near the end of the bus route.
Yeah, we'll do it.
Sometimes an adult assistant may be present. One assistant will need to know how to turn the bus off and set the emergency parking brake. That student will also need to know how to use the radio communication system. The assistant must also know how to turn on the emergency flashers and extend the side stop arm to alert oncoming traffic. If the bus driver happens to be injured, this assistant must take charge.
If for some reason your bus driver becomes incapacitated, if they pass out or lose consciousness or are unable to drive your bus, then an older student should know how to bring the bus to a stop. You need to come to the front of the bus. There's a yellow button. It's a parking brake. You need to pull it out while the bus is moving. And then after the bus has stopped, turn the key off to the off position and place the engine select, the transmission selector in neutral. If the driver has a problem for any reason and he cannot handle the bus or he passes out, then you need to come up, grab the steering wheel, set the park brake, and turn off the key.
Two assistants will be chosen to help students get off the front of the bus. And two more assistants will be chosen to help students get off from the rear emergency exit. The assistants will also be taught how to use the fire extinguisher. Written instructions showing how and where to get assistance in emergencies, along with telephone numbers, should be posted in the bus. Certain types of emergencies may require the assistants to help students out the side exit windows or through the roof hatches. Remember, your bus driver is always the boss, but you'll need to follow the instructions of the assistants as well. Their job is to keep you safe. Always stay calm and quiet as you follow their directions. If your bus happens to be in an emergency situation, your first job is to get off the bus as quickly and orderly as possible. Do not take backpacks, lunchboxes, or anything else with you. Leave them behind and follow the instructions from the driver or his assistants.
Students, remember, in an emergency situation, you must stay calm, be cool, follow the rules. Remember, follow the bus driver's instructions.